The Powered Enclosure Kit consists of a NEMA-rated enclosure, mounting hardware, an EG3000 meter, and either a TP-Link access point or Multitech cell modem. I have pre-drilled some holes in this enclosure and attached some Velcro. Install the two DIN rails. Note the different thicknesses. The thicker rail goes on the left and the thinner rail on the right. Install using the included screws and washers. Run the incoming voltage connection, including a neutral, ground, and all hot phases. There should be 3 to 6 inches of wiring inside the enclosure. Install the provided terminal blocks. Each block has a single connection on one side and a double connection on the other. The single connection side should face incoming wiring. Clip the terminal blocks into place on the DIN rail. Clip should be attached to the center side of the rail first, then the outer side of the rail. Repeat installation for remaining terminal blocks. Ensure terminal blocks are firmly attached to the DIN rail and slide together freely. Next, install the receptacle block. I wired this one off camera with about 6 inches of wiring and bent the wiring into a U-shape to simplify installation. Connect the receptacle block wiring to the terminal blocks. Make sure to use the lower connection point to leave room for the eGauge wiring. Clip the receptacle block into place. Make sure it is snug against the terminal blocks. Install the terminal block end cap. Note the pins. These should clip into place on the end of the terminal block with slight pressure. Install the retaining clips. These hold the terminal block and the receptacle block tightly together. Again, clip from the middle side of the rail first. Note that the outer screw should be tightened to secure the retaining clips. Ensure that everything is firmly attached to the DIN rail. Next, wire and install the eGauge 5-pin power plug. I have wired the 5-pin plug off camera with approximately 6 inches of wiring. Take note of the phasing when installing wiring. The ground is not connected to the eGauge. Note that one pin on the 5-pin plug is not used. The neutral and L1 phase will share the same terminal blocks with the receptacle block. The L2 and L3 phase will have their own terminal blocks. Tuck the eGauge 5-pin power plug to the side. The eGauge is installed using a set of DIN clips. These are attached using the pre-drilled holes at the top and bottom of the eGauge. Use the holes on the center and left side of the eGauge. The CT and Ethernet ports should face the center of the enclosure. The DIN rail mount should be attached using the included screws. Note the orientation of the DIN rail mounts. As with the other DIN rail mounted items, clip to the center side of the DIN rail first. Connect the 5-pin power plug to the eGauge. If installing the Multitech cell modem, continue watching. If installing the TP-Link access point, skip ahead to the next option. The Multitech should be installed with the antenna ports pointing towards the bottom of the enclosure and the Ethernet port pointing towards the top. The Multitech comes with a mounting rail, two DIN rail mounts, and screws. Install the mounting rail by inserting it into the groove on the back of the Multitech. Feed the mounting rail in from the antenna connection side. Attach the DIN rail mounts to the mounting rail. There will be some play in the mounting rail. This is normal. Attach the antenna connector to the Multitech. Be sure to use the cell connector on the right side. The antenna connector can be extended to reach a variety of locations, depending on mounting considerations. Clip the Multitech into place, starting from the center side of the DIN rail. Remove the nut from the antenna connector. Install the provided O-ring. Install the antenna connector in the desired location using the nut. It may be necessary to adjust the location of the terminal box and receptacle when using the Multitech. This can be accomplished by loosening the retaining clip screws and sliding the whole assembly along the DIN rail. Install the Ethernet cable between the eGauge and Multitech. Install the power supply for the Multitech. Note the threaded plug on the Multitech and integrated retaining nut on the power supply. Install the external antenna. The antenna is hinged and can be used in a variety of locations to get the best possible signal. The TP-Link access point has connectors located across the back of the device. It should be attached to the inside of the enclosure door using the provided Velcro strips. The strip should be installed in such a way that the TP-Link is approximately centered on the door. The TP-Link also has an adjustable antenna. This can be attached directly to the TP-Link or at various locations on the outside of the enclosure using the provided antenna connector. To install the antenna connector, remove the nut and install the provided O-ring. Use the nut to secure the connector to the enclosure. Connect the other end of the antenna connector to the TP-Link. Connect the Ethernet cable between the eGauge and TP-Link. Connect the power supply to the TP-Link and receptacle block. Install the external antenna. When closing, make sure the wiring for the TP-Link does not catch in the hinges.